Aries, welcome back to the channel. I hope you're all doing well. Doing something that you love today, and let's just get right into it. It's been a while, but yeah, hope you're in good health, good wealth. And Aries, oh, if you guys are in Florida, I hope everybody's okay. I hope you guys are evacuating. I know there's like the hurricane that's coming. Yeah, it looks like it's going to be pretty serious. So for everyone out in Florida that's watching, or if you know somebody in Florida, yeah, I hope you guys are all safe. I hope it doesn't get as bad as they're saying it's going to get, because it just looks like a lot. But yeah, that's important. That's important. I hope you guys are doing good, staying safe. But let's get into your reading. We're just going to pull some cards, check on the energies that are showing up for you. Take what resonates, leave the rest, of course. Feel good to be back. I'm happy to be back. I was going to go live, but I don't know. Something about the energy just didn't feel right yet. But I'm excited to be going live soon. Let's get this beautiful fake flower in the pic. Aries. All right. Yeah, just take what resonates. Probably start out with some oracle cards, actually. We got the lovers on the bottom. Love could be showing up for you guys. Who knows? Page of cups, knight of cups under that. Decisions. Important decisions at that. But let's just pull out some general energies for you, Aries. And see what we got. Spirit, thank you for any and all messages channeled through me for my Aries. And this will be for any and all Aries placements, right? So Aries sun, moon, rising, Venus. It resonates, it resonates. Today I saw a squirrel in my front yard. I saw a squirrel that was like, I don't know what they had in their mouth. I assume it was food. They were burying something. They were burying some food in my front yard. And I only bring it up because I've never seen it before, but wise of the squirrel, storing something for later. Storing something for later. Planting something. Spirit, what do you got for my Aries at this time? Any energies? I'll pull out three. Okay. Aries, bottom of the deck, we have impatience. So there could be definitely something that, a situation that you're dealing with in your life where you're kind of growing impatient, you know, with a person, place, or a thing. Really wanting to get things moving forward. Feeling like it's time for something to move forward, or it's time for something to be addressed or done, you know? So you could be growing impatient, but spirit, I guess offering, you know, offering your patience is a wonderful thing, but you can't wait forever, right? Especially if it's something that's in your control, right? You can only control what you can control. So if it's outside of you, you know, it is what it is, I guess. But if it's something that is within your means of controlling, then, you know, spirit's encouraging you to like take action or take the necessary steps to get whatever you're trying to get done or address. But what we got for you out first, Aries, we have growth. So a lot of you guys have been doing the work, right? You've been investing your energy in places that provide growth, right? Especially results. I'm getting results from this. So you might be feeling more, seeing more results within your work or whatever it is that you do, relationships, business, love, right? But there's something here that's growing. And it's, I feel like it's something that, it could even be something that is regrowing. Oh, wow, look at this. Squirrel with the nut. Interesting. But something here is growing, Aries, and it could be something that you've been nurturing, right? Something that you've been really investing yourself into. But whatever it is, it's like there's life. It's coming to life. Whatever it is you're doing or investing in, it's coming to life. And a lot of you guys have been really just trusting your instincts, or you're being encouraged to keep trusting your instincts with this. Whatever it is you want to do, or the direction you want to head in, you know, you're feeling something here, Aries. And a lot of you could be really, don't know, this feels like being ready to take things to the next level, or like a step up, you know what I mean? With growth and instinct, like knowing where to go, what to do, how to do it. Following your intuition with something here seems to be really important. Or it's like almost like you know what to do, but it's not moving forward yet. And so that's where this impatience could, this impatient energy could kind of be coming in at this time. Especially if it's in regards to like your passion projects, or I don't know, things that you want to invest in. It's like you have a good idea, a good business plan, a good way forward to move something forward. But something might, there might be a blockage somewhere, I want to say, that's coming up, because I'm also seeing this victim and this guilt card. So these could be energies that you've been working through, right? Things you've been growing through, doing the healing work, right? I don't know. It feels like you're leaving a certain mindset behind. You know, a mindset that might have created blockages, or I don't know. It's like you're outgrowing certain energies, people, places, and things, or maybe you're growing impatient with certain energies, right? These people, places, or things that kind of have that victim mentality. It's like you're outgrowing something, or you're elevating beyond something. And your instincts could be really calling you or pushing you in a new direction, Aries, into your power, right? Into a more, into like an energy that's more aligned with where you are now currently, right? So you could be kind of doing healing work or purging certain energies out of yourself, your life in general, that would have held you back or are holding you back, you know? So there could be a lot of focus there, you know? Just trusting yourself, trusting your gut, moving in a direction that's gonna serve you. Because at the end of the day, something is creating this impatience, Aries, and spirit's giving you a green light. You know what I mean? There's like a green light to continue to grow in a certain direction and leave behind energies that maybe try to make you feel guilty. You know what I mean? Like energies that try to make their problems a you thing. You know, energies that are not taking accountability, energies that try to put themselves in a victim mindset and make you feel bad about their lack of growth. You know, you could be really growing impatient with those certain energies. And so just, I see a lot of you just trusting your instincts and really outgrowing things that no longer serve you at this time. But let's see what these are about. Get into the tarot. Okay. This feels like a, yeah, Aries. No longer letting anyone or anything hold you back. Spirit, what's this growth about for Aries? Any cards, any tarot cards that want to come out? We got the Eight of Wands out first for you, Aries. So yeah, again with this like moving energy, right? This is the Eight of Wands is a, we have Sagittarius energy here, but it's just a card of like, there's movement here that's happening, but it's almost like focused movement. There's purpose behind this movement, right? There's a lot of investing yourself or investing energy in a specific direction, right? Having a certain desire and things moving forward because of the work and effort that you've been putting in to whatever this desire is. This is also a card of, I want to say, like communication. So In regards to growth, it's like the way that you address things, the way that you address things might be a lot more, there's growth within it, right? The way that you're communicating with others, or that you allow others to communicate with you, seems there's like growth in that. Like if an energy like this shows up in your life where they're playing the victim or trying to make you feel guilty, I'm getting this sense like you're handling something in a lot more graceful way. You know, you're not getting triggered by the same old things that used to, because of the growth that you've been doing, because of the ways that you've been spiritually evolving. You know what I mean? So I'm just seeing the movement in a certain direction here. And with this Nine of Swords, there could be a bit of overthinking taking place. You know what I mean? There could be a bit of overthinking about how things are growing, moving, and shifting. So it's going to be really beneficial at this time to continue to trust your instincts, right? You might not be able to like see what the outcome's going to be, but you're being encouraged to continue to take those steps, right? Step by step, taking steps in that direction that you're moving, and kind of continuing to take the steps and following your instincts will help mitigate some of those fears. And with the Empress here, so what's growing, Aries, truly is your vision. It is the abundance. What's growing is the within you is starting to reflect itself outside of you, I want to say. You might start to see things growing around you, relationship-wise, your manifestations actually growing and coming to life, and actually moving in the direction that is best serving you. But there could be a bit of uncertainty because of the unpredictability, you know what I mean, in regards to like what's taking place at this time for you energetically. But these are all really, I'm just getting this sense that where you're investing your energy, or where you continue to invest your energy, it's like, what's a good analogy? Almost like planting a garden, right? Planting a garden at the beginning of the summer, but then, and obviously having your expectations, but these are what's growing might exceed your expectations, or you might surpass those expectations if you continue to put in the work. So Spirit's just encouraging you to kind of recognize what the fear is, in that it's just fears, right? These are not things that are actually, they're not here to stop your growth, right? These are whatever fears are coming up or arising, they're meant to help you grow, right? The ways in which you kind of process, address, learn, and heal from whatever it is you're dealing with, it's here to help you grow. So the direction things are moving is self, and is in a very self-empowered direction, I want to say. You could be taking your power back, feeling more empowered, feeling more certain about yourself, but maybe uncertain about how where things are really heading, because they're heading somewhere. You know what I mean? Things are moving in a direction and it seems very prosperous, but there is a bit of uncertainty here, or fear that's showing up. Can you show me with instincts? We got the Seven of Wands out. So yeah, standing your ground, right? Standing for what you believe in. So trusting your instincts in regards to what it is you're fighting for, right? Defending yourself, especially from energies that do not serve you at this time. But just following your instincts in regards to like, what are you building? What are you creating? What do you want for yourself? See for yourself, and then standing up for yourself in regards to it, right? Sticking to the vision step by step. Ace of Swords and Aries, you got a vision. There's something here that's becoming more clear to you, right? Whether it's what you no longer can bring with you, what is not yours to carry. You know what I mean? Like other people's. You can only control what you can control. And I see an Aries here who's getting very clear about what is their energy and what is not, you know, becoming more aware of what it is you stand for, what you can control, and what's not yours to carry, right? Like other people projecting onto you, it's not necessarily your job to carry it for them, you know? That's just an example. But when it comes to your instinct, spirit is saying, I'm seeing an Aries here who's just getting really clear on the ways in which there may have been opportunities missed in the past due to maybe overthinking or not taking action, right? Not taking action when your instincts were telling you to. But an Aries who is more clear about, like, an Aries who has learned from that, an Aries who is now standing up for themselves, speaking their truth, getting rid of the, not the middleman, but the it's like getting out of your feelings about something, you know what I mean? Getting out of your feelings and taking action on your instincts. I don't know, there's something here showing up that maybe it might challenge you. I want to say it might bring up some challenges, but these again are opportunities for growth, Aries. So you might be finding a lot more of those situations show up for you. And with this victim and guilt card, we have the King of Cups out first. So there could be somebody or something, right? See, I want to say, like, when I was speaking on, like, you outgrowing certain energies, I feel like you're handling, or the work you've been doing on yourself, right? Spiritually, emotionally, you're starting to see that. It's like what you've been through, what you've gone through has only made you stronger. I'm seeing an Aries here who's very, very centered within themselves and their emotions, right? No longer letting past situations create stagnancy or confusion, but still having to deal with them, still having to deal with energies that are showing up and creating a sense of lack in a way, right? Or maybe trying to project these situations and emotions onto you, but just like how you handle it is, I feel like it's different now, right? I feel like you're in this Empress energy of knowing one's worth and not really letting old paradigms or older energies kind of keep you bogged down anymore. You know what I mean? But with this King of Cups, Five of Pentacles, Two of Pentacles over the victim and guilt sort of energy, this could be an energy coming through that's like, I don't know, maybe there was a past situation that you had with them where there was a lot of love. It doesn't even have to be past, right? This could be just someone that in your life that has a lot of love for you, or you have a lot of love for, but it's like something about this energy kind of keeps you in a certain limbo, or keeps some sort of, you know, it doesn't feel good. It doesn't necessarily feel good externally, but there is love there. And so moving on from this or working through this, there could be a lot of like guilt tripping or victim mentality that they kind of, I don't know, try to play you with, you know, somebody that tries to create certain narratives because they know that there's love there, taking advantage of that. But I don't know, I see you kind of outgrowing a lot of situations or energies and growing impatient because you see what you want or the direction you're trying to head now. Something's becoming more clear for you, Aries. I like it. I like it a lot. What would you like to leave Aries with? Number 12. I'm a visionary. So number 12 could be coming up. Some of you could be a life path. 1, 2, 3. But it says creativity is a driving force in your life. Your imagination is rich and you're able to express your feelings and insights in unique ways that others can benefit from. Bringing the vision to life, Aries. This is what spirit has for you. Take what resonates, leave the rest, and I'll see you guys soon. If you want to follow me on social media, donate to the channel, book a personal. Links will be in the description box below or my About tab. And I'll see you soon.